So shaking the body, both voluntarily and involuntarily, is one of the greatest taboos our society has, because our society is not designed for our freedom. And shaking the body is really, it's the most empowering and liberating thing that we can do with this body, because it kind of brings in the electricity of God, it brings in the energy of God. We're shaking away all the tension, all the resistance, because you can't be in a state of resistance when you're shaking something. Resistance is like a fist. That is a symbol of resistance. Okay? So if you want to free yourself of resistance, you have to shake off the tension, because resistance is tension and tension is fear. So this is why shaking is one of our society's biggest taboos, because it really brings deep and powerful liberation. It really empowers us in a way we can't even comprehend. So because we live in a Judeo-Christian society, and shaking is very much connected to the snake. In fact, there's only one letter difference: shake and snake. The similarity there is intentional. And of course, we associate the snake with evil, with the Garden of Eden. Many, of course, Christians in general associate the snake with Satan. And that's kind of filtered into our society over hundreds and hundreds of years, thousands of years even, that we have this fear or mistrust of anything snake-like. Like we talk about a snake oil salesman, someone we don't trust. And so we connect snake and shake because of the similarity in spelling, and because some snakes shake, like the rattlesnake, then we put those two things together, and we connect shaking with something evil. We connect shaking with something that comes from the devil. It's like being possessed. But in fact, quite the opposite is true. Well, no, you are being harnessed. Your body's being harnessed by God. Because when you let go of all resistance, and most of our resistance, believe it or not, is to God. We think we're resisting the bad things in our life. We think we're resisting our fear, or resisting our temptation, or we think we're resisting things which are threatening. But actually what we're resisting is God. If we're in resistance, we're resisting God. Because if we trust God completely, then our body is open. There's no resistance, there's no fear, because we trust completely that there's no threat. Because when we're protected completely, we are not threatened. So do you trust that God is protecting you completely? If you do, then let go of the tension. Let go of the resistance. Let go of the fear. And shaking is the most powerful way, by far. And I've been exploring this realm of things for over 20 years. Shaking the body is by far the most powerful and direct way of releasing fear, which is tension and resistance. When you're afraid, your body tenses up and it goes into a state of resistance. And this is what is stopping us receiving the beautiful light and love of God, which is waiting to pour into us, but we are resisting it. It doesn't matter why, or doesn't matter who's persuaded us to resist it. The fact is, are we in a state of tension? And most of us are. Most of us are holding tension in different parts of our body. And over decades, that tension gets stuck there. And that's how disease and illness manifests in certain parts of our body, because we've been holding that part of our body tense so long, subconsciously, that it can't get the oxygen, the blood, the life it needs, because it's densified, it's become dense. And so the energy, the circulation of our blood and oxygen is not getting there. And so that's when disease comes up in certain parts of our body, because our body is meant to be relaxed and open so that our life force flows freely, so that our energy, our physical energy flows freely, but most importantly, so that we receive the light and the love of God, the energy of God, the power of God. Our body's been designed for that. And we'll realize this. We'll realize this if we just let go of the resistance, let go of the fear. And of course, in Christianity, and I'm very aware of this because I am a born-again Christian since the age of 33. I'm 42 years old now, and I have a lot of Christian friends, a lot of good Christian friends, different denominations, and And there is this, how can I put this? This fear of opening up to something that which might be threatening. Fear of opening up to some dark energies, or fear of opening up to some bad spirits. So if you relax your body, if you're open and receptive, then maybe you'll be receptive to bad spirits. Now, I understand that psychology, but it's not true. It is not true. No way. Because fear is present. That means all the things which are connected to fear. Fear is the soil of evil. You have to understand that. That evil grows in the soil of fear. And so we can only be in a state of fear when we're in a state of tension. So this whole mechanism of evil and darkness and destructiveness, it all comes through being in a state of tension, because tension is resistance to God. It's really important to understand this, that when you're relaxed and open, then you can only be open to the force of God. You can only be open to the light and the love and all the wonderful gifts that God has to give you. Nothing can threaten you when you're open to the power of God. You're only threatened when you are resisting God in a state of tension, a state of anxiety. And that's when we have our darker experiences. That's when we go into more fears, states of fear, more states of pessimism, more states of anxiety, when we're tense. Just notice it the next time you feel negative, anxious or worried. Notice your body and you'll see that it's being held tense. And as soon as we relax, the tension fades away. And we cannot be in fear anymore. We can only experience fear while our body is in a state of tension. The moment we relax, that means our body is no longer tense and fear can no longer be present. So that's the state where we're fully open to the light of God. That's the state when we fully commune, you could say, fully receive God's energy. That's what our body is designed for, to receive God's energy.
Seeking for you. Don't be afraid.
Look for love. Seeking for you.